Hey everybody, Hitch here with another game from the After Hours Gaming League with Team NVIDIA. Today, Team NVIDIA is going to be taking on Fact Set Research. So we're getting into the picks and bans stage here. And the first ban will go to Team NVIDIA. Remember, these are best of ones, so first ban's actually pretty important. So let's take a look and see who Fact Set Research are real quick. They're supporting the charity of Camp Rising Sun. Camp Rising Sun is a camp for children who have faced a diagnosis of cancer. Camp gives to children ages 5 to 17 the opportunity to remember the joys of childhood, how to laugh, and how to play. And on this team we have Weekoff, Blaskovich, Minjit, Terpsfan, 1989, and Nacho Cheese. So we got a ban of the Faceless Void. No first ban Brew coming out from NVIDIA. Like we've seen, usually first ban Juggernaut. He's very common to be banned in these trying times. Okay, second ban Bristleback coming out from NVIDIA. Maybe we're switching up their style a little bit without breaking out the Brewmaster ban. So first pick, Centaur Warrunner, probably going on Cragglenaut, Dire's of course. Pick. So Dire coming up. We'll probably come out and see the support combo of Centaur Warrunner and Vengeful Spirit if it isn't picked away by FactSet Research, NVIDIA's favorite laning duo. So we'll see how this goes off. We got the first pick coming out from FactSet now. The captain of the team.
10 seconds to go.
Figuring out exactly how he's going to run this.
5 seconds.
Ah, running with an axe, Dire's so they might do big. the axe. Well, axe has just been going really, really well for a lot of people lately. So, see how they handle that. Got axe, Centaur Warrunner. He's probably pull some creep skipping early on. Get their early game rolling, and if he's does well enough, he can stay without falling off in the mid to late game. Might pair it up with an Omni Knight to do the hill call combo. Ah, but they're going for a Lion. A lot of control in the
Radiant's pick.
The fights with Lion. So second pick coming out from NVIDIA. Either gonna see the Vengeful Spirit or something else usually. See how they're deciding to run it this week. They might pick the Brewmaster because they haven't banned it like they usually do. The brew hate is no longer real, so. Oh, give me 1 second here. Gotta turn my cast on in the game. There it is. Haha. There it is. The Vengeful Spirit, like we've come to expect and see from probably the LDC hero there. Her signature spirit. So we'll see if the brew gets banned now with this next ban pit phase. So far, Axe Lion versus Centaur Warrunner and Vengeful Spirit. Centaur Warrunner probably run an aggressive tri lane with either a Shadow Shaman or a Witch Doctor, depending on who they decide to go with.
5 seconds.
5 seconds left on the ban. Reserve time. Use a little bit up.
Reserve
in this ban phase. So, not going for the brew. So they banned Invoker, so they don't want to handle any of Invokers. With Invoker ban, you might be. Might be worried about purges from other heroes.
It's here with another game from the After.
Ignore that. Alright. So, Lion, Axe. Let's see, they banned the Death Prophets, so. Looks like they're trying to prevent any push strategies here, because these are all decent. These two are decent pushing heroes that can bring a team around. So, they're worried about either early push or. They want to center around team fights, which is what NVIDIA likes to do as well. So positioning probably going to be a very big deal in this best of one for the After Hours Gaming League.
5 seconds.
Next ban coming out from NVIDIA. Will we see the brew ban? I don't know. Oh, Witch Doctor ban. So they'll probably grab a Shadow Shaman for themselves if it isn't banned away or picked by FactSet Research. So very good bans coming out from both teams. There are a lot of things you don't want to have to go up against, including the current Juggernaut that is Juggernaut.
To go.
Ugh, that was a bad one.
That's, 5 seconds.
5 seconds left in the banning period. So far I haven't used up any reserve time, but it looks like, oh, there's the ban on the Shadow Shaman. They see kind of what NVIDIA are going for a control set of heroes, so we'll see what comes out next from them. They're looking for some teamfight heroes. Might see an Omni Knight actually out on their side, just to get a some heals. The heal bomb with the axe, the slow, combined with Lion. They might go for a Murano or a Shadow Demon is also a good pick here, just for the you can do the disruption into Spike into Call.
10 seconds to go.
A lot of really good things here. I wouldn't be surprised to see another stunner if they're planning to go as much team fight as Team NVIDIA usually goes. Dipping into their reserve time with this pick. Maybe they were planning on using one of these heroes as their mid laner, because they still have to pick up probably one more support, an off laner, and a mid laner. Because I would be very surprised to see Axe not in an aggressive tri lane. So we'll see what they pick. Disruptor. Okay, Disruptor. Want to keep people together. See, like I said, another positioning team fighting hero. So probably using the glimpse back into spikes into call. Another great. I love this Disruptor hero because he keeps people there, silences. He's just a really great team fighting hero. So one team for Team NVIDIA don't have a lot of counter push if NVIDIA decide to use that strat, but they have the Death Prophet and Shadow Shaman banned, so it's gonna be a little bit harder for them to find heroes that go well with that. Hex coming.
Five seconds.
This much control, it's gonna be hard to pick into. Maybe using a Brew to kind of get away from the
reserve.
No, Brew would be really hard because you have the Hex and the Silence and stuff. Just because he's on my mind because they've always first banned the Brew, so I'm really curious to see if they're trying to use it themselves. Who knows? Maybe I might even see the Bounty Hunter from Hayuken over here. Okay, a Jakiro. Okay, there's that other lockdown support that they like to go for. So it'll be stun, into ice path, into stomp, lots of control. Coming out from both teams right now, so we're going to have to see Axe a little stronger than Centaur War Runner in this current meta, this latest patches, but doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be an easy win for them. So these appear to be our aggressive tri-lanes. I would say Disruptor, Lion, Axe, probably a little bit favored just because of the blinks. The glimpse is going to be online before the swap, so it'll be easier for them to get in a position to pull off their wombos rather than having to wait for the swap, waiting for the blink dagger from Centaur War Runner. And the blink dagger coming out from Axe, he usually farms a little bit quicker just because of the spin to win than Centaur War Runner. So both of these heroes both needing a blink to get their initiations off. But very similar team fighting styles coming out from both sides. The only thing I think that NVIDIA has going for them is Jakiro also can help push towers, and then the area of control with the macro pyre and the dual breath and even the liquid fire. So you're gonna have to really worry about that AoE damage, especially on the squishier Lion and Disruptor supports. So I mean, I am of course assuming that they're not gonna be playing Disruptor core in the I've seen it done. You can do it. It's just late game. He doesn't do enough damage to really make it worth it. So who knows? They could switch it up on me and throw an axe mid for all I know. So we got the Vengeful Spirit, Centaur War Runner, and all that good stuff going. Next pick coming out, a Queen of Pain. So Queen of Pain probably sitting in the mid lane. A lot of people have a very hard time up against the Queen of Pain, so we'll see. Viper, okay, good choice against the Queen of Pain, because she doesn't have a high health pool, so every time she harasses or does anything, you can level the Corrosive Skin early and go for that, or you can just get the Nether Toxin early and just end the poison attack and just try to make her pay every time she goes for even one CS and just keep her back in the back lane. So anti-fun banned. I'm glad to see it, because this is such a boring hero. But so good. Alright, well. Used up a lot of their reserve time on these picks for FactSet Research, but they're coming towards the end of the phase, so it's not that big of a deal. Probably won't see any accidental auto picks coming out from this these reserve time. So really thinking about their last ban here, trying to figure out what that last offlane hero could be. You know, maybe a Clockwork would work well. Because you can hookshot in, blink in, kill. So we'll see what they decide to go. Even a Legion Commander could be good, just for getting the control on. If you can get the control on one hero on this team, and you have this lineup to just get in there and mess with them, It's going to be pretty difficult to fight into. Hell, even with the glimpse somebody back, duel, everybody blows them up. And then there's nothing this repositioning team can do except for try to swap him out and sacrifice the Vengeful Spirit. Either way, you get a dual kill. A lot of good options, though. I mean, so they think about a game with 120 heroes. They're going for the Slark. Never a bad idea. Really? He also has that pounce to keep people where you want him. So, another good... And plus, let's face it, it's Slark. You know, you get your Shadow Dance, you... Even if you have a bad initiation, if you can get away with your leap, you can wander around, heal up, and come back. So, see how NVIDIA are planning to counter that. They can run the Viper in the offlane if they decide to, and pick a different mid laner to go up against this Queen of Pain.
10 seconds to go.
Just because you're going to want somebody who can really challenge the Slark. They even might even throw the Axe in the offlane and throw the Slark in the aggressive try just to try to get him some kills early on.
Reserve time.
There's a lot of options for Team Fact Set. They did their research, clearly. So, since that same thing goes for NVIDIA, there's the control offlaners would be a real... I would think it would be a really good options here, like the Clockwork or the Legion Commander. The only thing you have to worry about is, as with any initiation heroes, initiating into all this burst damage. You got the scream, the finger, the chop, and you can even jump yourself into a static storm if you don't hit the disruptor or get it silenced immediately. And then, of course, Slark will just essence shift away all this stuff. This is going to be a really challenging team to fight into. The only thing that NVIDIA have really going for them right now is the amount of control coming out from these three can... If you can get a good counter initiation, like they jump in. So the counter initiation, I think, is going to be a big part of this match. Because any dirty initiations will be severely punished from the other side. Especially if you initiate into the wrong hero. So, 10 seconds left.
10 seconds to go.
And that's on their reserve time. We might see an auto pick if they're not careful. 5 seconds. Spectre. Ooh, that is a juicy pick with these three squishies here. Very interesting. All right, so they're running Nacho Cheese on the Slark, Minjit on the Queen of Pain, Axe is going to be played by Terpsvand, Blaskovich on the Disruptor, and Weakoff on the line. Good luck, fun coming out from Minjit. Meanwhile, on Team NVIDIA, Kragelnaut, of course, going on his Centaur War Runner. You've got Noob, on the Jakiro. Bantakoon rocking the very nice looking Spectre, and LDC on the Vengeful Spirit. Meanwhile, that leaves Hayuken the Captain rocking mid lane on his Viper. So both teams getting ready. Looks like there's gonna be some rune contention as the two bounty runes at the beginning. Axe coming in the side here, dropping an aggressive ward so he can see everything that's happening around there. That is a good ward to have because it gives you vision over this entire area.
What's with all the scribbling?
Alright, so you're riding on the map, suggesting a hook around. Slark's waiting. He's already skilled pounce. He's got the Lion there too. Come on. There we go. Lion and the Disruptor. Sec please on Bantakoon. Large ping problem coming out. So there's the pause coming out from Team NVIDIA. They're having a big ping problem, they say. Nothing leveled up for the Centaur War Runner. See, Blaskovich, nothing leveled. Weakoff, nothing leveled. Queen of Pain going straight for the Shadow Strike. Terpsvand, it's got the counter helix, so he's not planning on going in on this bottom rune, which is probably going to go straight the way of Spectre if they have their way. So Spectre leveled the Spectral Dagger. It's a very good escape technique, which you want to have at these early levels before Spectre can come online. Yeah, you can tell Hayuken's lagging a little bit. Usually he's a little more involved in these first team fights and whatnot, so. As with all games lately, the servers are causing some lag issues. So we're gonna be sitting in this pause, get our last hits ready to go. As soon as they come out, we'll be seeing what they can do. Viper DCing and probably re-seeing here in a second. See any interesting buys? Nothing so far. No tally coming out to deal with some of the damage coming out from Viper, which they know they're going up against. Ringer protects and Stout Shield, so maybe he is. He's just going to be offlaning on this axe. So that puts Slark in the aggressive try. He's got a Stout Shield as well to deal with some of the physical damage coming out from Kragelnaut on the Centaur War Runner. But I think the thing he's going to have to worry about is the Sword of coming out from Hayuk, and that's always a good sign. Saying, it's sort of better. It's not exactly the answer you ever want to see when you're coming up to this sort of situation. Okay, we got a G coming out from Hayuken, so they're good to go. G coming out from Turf's fan as we go into this battle for rune control. Both teams getting ready. I really like this Centaur set, by the way. It's the Dota Cinema set. All right, here they come. Week off, Nacho Chi showing themselves. Kragelnaut seeing it, and he's just going to back off.
And they're off.
So that's probably going to be a free bounty rune for Nacho Cheese. And Bonsacoon grabbing the one on the Spectre. So team's shaking out into their prospective lanes. No first bloods, nothing yet, but don't worry, it's coming. See how the blocks are coming out for Hayuken. He comes up in this mid lane. Oop, there's a ping out here. They find the ward and deward it instantly. It's got to be rough for the axe. He really needed that ward, because when you're up against a aggressive try that is as stun lock as this one is, you're going to waste a lot of your time being nervous. Meanwhile, Bonsacoon drains down a ward of his own, and it's not dewarded, so he can see anybody coming out, maybe Blazkowicz coming out from the side and trying to get behind Kragelnaut. Right now, he's happy to just stay in XP range, not going for any last hits yet, but the Spectre doing very well. Three last hits already. As the mid laners do their deathly dance in the trades. Shadow Strikes coming out on Hayuken, doing a bit of damage to him, but nothing. Yeah, like I said, oh, there he goes. He goes Corrosive Skin, Nether Toxin almost immediately. Oh, they deward this poor Centaur's ward. As he goes in, tries to defend, he says, no, don't deward my ward. It's my only hope. So let's see if Kragelnaut can. He can't, doesn't have any vision, can't get a counter ward, so right now he's just harassing Week Off away from it. He's behind this tree. They can't see him, so he's going to try to run out and stomp it, but there's two supports here. He can't really go up against this. He's going to have to back off and head back to the forest. Meanwhile, up top, they're putting some real pressure on this axe. Or up top, down bottom. Kragelnaut as well, feeling the pressure of the offlane as he runs back and eats a tango. So he didn't get to finish defending his ward, and he's just going to have to sit in this bottom lane. And he's finally leveled up a hoof stomp, and he still has another point in case he needs it for something else. Okay, dropping it into a double edge so he can get that nice burst damage to get a kill. Okay, denies. Wow, Spectre really doing well in this soft lane. Or this tri lane. So they got Haste Rune grabbed by Noob as he runs in. He's going to try to get behind the Axe, but Axe is already backed far beyond the tower. The bounty rune, really important rune at this stage of the game, just being kind of left there to do nothing as Kragelnaut gets harassed back under his tower. He's doing a good job of trying to keep the creepilibrium towards him. So you can admit, been trading blows with this Queen of Pain, but neither one of them look like they're in any danger of dying. No bottle out for either side yet. They're just kind of working on it. Getting close, though. Hayuken has enough for the bottle, but it doesn't look like he'll be going bottle on this this Viper. Nacho Cheese leveling Pounce and Dark Pact. Just want to get the wave clear ready before he goes for any essence shifting. But once he has that essence shift online, the Kragelnaut's really going to have to be worried on that Centaur War Runner. So, last hit's going very well for Team NVIDIA. They're getting a lot out of these lanes. Really doing well as far as that's concerned. The battle room's still just chilling there. Even though the dire can, they have a ward up and can see that it's there, but I guess they just don't want to wander down that way yet. As you can come in, looks like he's just doing some zoning. He's like, I'm here. And he's going to start spitting on Minjit. And just taking his last hits as he does. Minjit, even when she gets a hit on him, it looks like she's taking almost as much damage as he is, as long as he's not in the Shadow Strike. So, Bonsacoon And Noob pushing back this poor axe who's not doing very well as far as farm-wise. Wow. 1,500 gold already that's up on the... Oh, come on! I missed the rotation mid as the Disruptor and the Lion come up and get the kill on Hayuken mid. That's going to be really good. And the bottle coming out. Bottle and boots. Whew. Coming out for Min Jit on the Queen of Pain. They see the boundary rune. They'll protect it and drop another ward to check out any dewarding, but they don't have to worry because there's no wards up for Team NVIDIA. So Kragelnaut needs to be careful. Here comes this roaming support duo, but he's going to be... He sees him coming. He's going to be back off and be just fine. And while these supports did their job very well and were rewarded with a few levels and things like that, let's take a look and see how our levels are doing overall. So overall, nobody hitting level 6 yet, of course, but you got your mid laner's 5, but ooh, yeah, your lane's going very well for NVIDIA. They've already got 2 level 4s, except for the Slark getting level 5 already. That's scary. And there's the level 6 for the Queen of Pain. She's got her ultimate online, and now she becomes really scary. Bottom lane being pinged out. They want to go on this axe, but they can't figure out how to do it exactly. Noob showing himself in the lane, throws out a harass and just blows it up. Kragonaut diving pretty deep here. He's got to be careful. He's trying to get pick off one of the supports on the back end. Weakoff coming in. There's the stomp. There's the chop. There's the glimpse back. And then the frog. If they have enough damage, here comes the spike. Slark slow on the keys, not coming in to get in on this. He's just going to sit there and farm. I think they could have had that kill if Slark would have made the rotation. He's got an essence shift. I see no reason not to go in on him there. Ooh. Min Jit getting down to half health in the mid lane, but she'll be fine. Noob starting to get ready to stack these camps so that way Spectre can just come in and clean them out. Spectre already level 5. Let's go back to let's check our current net worths. Spectre topping the charts here. Kragelnaut gets the stomp, gets the double edge. It's not going to be enough. He dodges the pounce. And Natural Cheese is going to have to back off. Kragelnaut needs... Okay, he's got his Tranquil Boots, so he can afford to be a little harassy. As Queen of Pain grabs and activates the boundary rune and heads back towards the mid lane. Now, this mid lane, I thought this Viper would do a lot more damage to the Min Jit, but the burst damage just being too much to handle at these lower levels before this gets tanky. Ooh, this Kragelnaut, he's just really harassing out this Slark. The Slark seems terrified, especially for a Slark. Usually you can see Slarks jumping in, being all crazy. Noob getting pinged out by the Dire side as they saw him rotate up in this lane with Kragelnaut. They're going to go for a kill. But meanwhile, the support's going back in mid, getting ready for another dive on Hayuken. They're going for it. Axe chasing down the Ventral Spirit, but not going to really trouble get anything.
Radiant's bottom tower.
Bottom tower getting messed up from LDC. Does another pull. Tried to go for the double pull, but only grabs one. Right now. Top Noob helping Kragelnaut get this tower pushed in, get some licks on it. This roaming duo smokes up, but they really haven't had much success doing anything. They're going to try to head back towards and do the wraparound on Hayuken. See if they can pull it off as they walk past their own ward. And coming in, they're getting ready. They reveal themselves with smoke. They're not in range for any spells, though. There's the glimpse. He's brought back. He throws out the Viper Strike onto the Lion. Here comes the scream. And he gets the Lion kill as somebody's porting in. Hayuken trying to get out of here. LDC getting in. No time to throw the stun as Blazkowicz coming out. Yeah, that is the opposite of the way you want that gank to go. If your team fact-checked research. Fact-set research, sorry.
Coming apart.
That was devastatingly bad for their team. Min Jit, though, gets a little bit of recovery with the regeneration rune. Kragelnaut coming up in this top lane. He's getting some more attacks on. Bonzakun getting pretty low, but he pops a salve and he'll be fine in this bottom lane. They ping out a Dire Observer ward over here at the rune spot. And LDC back to base, pick up some stuff. A Kragelnaut goes for the Nacho Cheese, but not enough chips to get that kill. Ooh, double edge. He's doing a lot of self damage, but he didn't get the last hit like he was really wanting in that lane. So Hayuken feeling a little bit safer after that deny of a gank, and he picked up his treads, which make him a lot tankier. Axe, he hacks, but he's still waiting for to get his blink dagger. Went tranquils first, never that terrible of a plan, but in lane it's going to be a little bit harder to get the full regen out of him like you'd like to. Noob coming back in with LDC, getting ready for the gank. Meanwhile, top, Kragonaut has to drop the charge as he needs to run away from Nacho Cheese. He'll barely get out of this with 43 life. LDC comes in, he misses, he gets the pounce out, but she throws the stun and gets stunned in return, but it looks like it's going to be just a fight for fighting's sake, as the Queen of Pain looking to make a rotation and ends up not getting anything. What kind of wasting her time as she has to, is forced back to go mid lane. Kragonaut though, forced back all the way base. They can count that as a somewhat of a victory, keeping him out of the lane. The Slark though, he's getting some work done as he's fighting the Spectre now for top net worth. It's Bontekun. He's got nearly 3,000 gold. I don't know what he's planning on going as Tempest Fan goes for the creep skip, but he just ends up finishing off the ranged creep. A lot of people going top. It looks like there's going to be spoil for a fight up here, but they're being spotted out by the Radiant Observer wards, so they're just staying well back. Kragonaut jumps in, goes for the Terps fan, double edge, stomped him, but nothing. Queen of Pain's here. She throws the dagger. Kragonaut needs to be careful. He's low. He's the blink. There's the jump. Is she have enough for the ultimate? She's bottling it back up. There it is. Going for the scream, and Kragonaut. Oh my god, he had 15 health, and they got the kill finally. As Hayuken comes in, looking to clean up Terps fan, he throws out the Viper Strike, and that's going to be it for him. Queen of Pain throwing out a dagger, but there's no way to save him. So an axe for Kragonaut, both the offlaners. One for one trade, and I want to say that's even. I didn't really see either team coming out too far ahead from that. Meanwhile, top lane, these poor Disruptor, he's been just kind of forced to waste his time as they... they all know exactly what he's up to with these Radiant Observer wards. Hayuken heads back to mid lane after the kill on the Axe, who I've heard hacks as far as they tell me. 3,500 gold on the Spectres, and he's finally got something coming out on the Courier. Oh no, he's got the Courier headed to the Secret Shop. Let's see what he picks up. Probably going to be the Sacred Relic, so he can head straight into his Radiance. Ooh, Stampede coming out from the Kragonaut as he picks off that Disruptor. Help a noob there for Kragonaut as they rotate back up here. Want to get a kill on the Slark and just go for the... Oh, just in time to see the Spectre and the Vengeful Spirit get just hacked down. So return kill across the map coming out better for FactSet, as their burst damage is just ridiculously hard to handle with this early stage in the game. It's coming out for Lion, that'll make him happy, as got 2,000 gold on the axe. He's getting very close to his blink dagger. Meanwhile, up top, Kragonaut, no, just trading blows with Nacho Cheese, as Minjit and Hayuken are doing their mid dance. Somebody pings out something over here. Spectral Dagger coming out and hitting weak off. Not doing a ton of damage at this point in the game. So, got Noob coming in, getting ready to help Bontekun in this offlane. As Disruptor plants some wards in this... Wow, double warding for the rune spot. Making sure that they have control and vision of there. So, Kragonaut gets some splatter damage on some creeps. And Lion there, pinging out the Lion, they want to get the kill on him, so here comes the stun duo, there's the first stun, here's the ice path, the yell, the fire, but then they get spiked, there's the dagger, is it going to be enough damage? She uses the haunt to get the extra damage in on the, wow, haunt used to secure a Lion kill, don't see that every day. But it looks like everybody else is going to be fine. Bontekun, oh, so close. Still has 3,200 gold though, so still getting close to the relic for the Scepter Rush. Minjit tossing out the harass, taking a lot of poison damage though. Blazkowicz coming in for this top lane kill. He's roaming it in, but he's spotted out and pinged out from the Radiant, so probably not going to end up getting a kill in this top lane. As, yeah, Cragglenaut just backs off on the Centaur Warwinder. Tracing out a hook as there's the blinking call, but he misses the call onto Banzakun. So he's just going to try to run in, but without any spins, I don't see how he can get this kill. There's the stampede to get the Spectre all the way to safety, but he's got everybody coming in on him. They really want to shut this Spectre down before he can get started. Meanwhile, top lane, Nacho Cheese is pinged out as Disruptor drops. Just drops the... what the hell is that thing called? The Thunderstrike. Oh no, there's the leap in onto Cragglenaut, but here comes the Sun coming back, but he was... under his invincibility, glimpsed back, and Blazkowicz and Nacho Cheese gonna run out of this. Meanwhile, Queen of Pain getting ready to dive in on Banzakun here as he... there's the blink, there's the call, just a little bit out. Here's the blink strike, there's the Shadow Dagger. Is it gonna be enough to get away from these people? But they're gonna... just gonna sit there, bounce back. Porting in, coming in from Hayuken, who gets immediately hit with... oh! Sees Minjit, goes for the strikes. She goes for the yell just to see if she can fight it, but that's going to be it, Minjit. Oh, but the finger finally reveals the Spectre, so it's going to be a one-for-one trade as Weak Al throws the frog and tries to get away, but that's going to be the end of him as Axe just blinks farther into the forest. Look at him. He's like, he's very scared out here on Terps Fan. Top lane? Nope. Didn't get the kill on Cragglenaut. So it'll be a two-for-one trade, but they traded the Spectre, who really needs to get online, and that's not, ooh, that is not the way they wanted that to go. Hayuken, though, coming in, making a great save. Making it, you know, still keeping his team ahead as he tops the Dartmouth. His mech, he's got the buckler in the mech recipe getting ready to come out to him now. That'll make a big difference having a mech this early on in these team fights. Okay, now a Dire Observer ward in this all important spot as Cragglenaut sits back and is just observed. So, noob. Kind of babysitting, grabbing his levels in this mid lane. He's picked up his level 6 in Macropyre. Anybody under level 6? Let's take a look. Yep, still the Disruptor with waiting to get his level 6. The only thing I would worry about is these two heroes right here for Team NVIDIA. That's their big main concern. Last hit game being won by the Slark, who's now forced back to base. But he's picked up his Shadow Blade. Picked up, you know, that gives him the movement speed and the regen. When no one can see him. It's not a bad pickup by Slark. So, Hayuken and Banzakun, they go clean up the forest. As Banzakun finds an illusion rune. Nobody going for Roche yet, but I suspect it's getting to be close to that time. Oh, Mana Drain instantly killing off the illusion from Weak Off. Yep, everybody decides now is the time to farm as they head back into the forest. LDC doing the same. Oh, Slark going for the initiation in onto Hayuken, but here comes the Spectre. Doesn't make it to one of her illusions in time. There's the jump in. Hayuken, really, they don't want him to die. He drops his mech charge, but there's a lot of essence shift going towards Nacho Cheese. It gets blown up! Oh no! Minjit on the backside blinks up and out. Wow, they lose Lion on the backside. Here comes that all-important Disruptor ult. Just as he hits 6, he gets it into a team fight as they run in and try to get another kill, but it's going to be the Centaur Warrunner traded for the Slark and the Lion. Wow, big turnaround from NVIDIA in that fight. That was... whew, it looked like they were really going to lose a hero or something there. Sacred Relic out on Banzakun making a big difference with that extra 60 damage coming out for him. Radiant not far off for the Spectre. Minjit heads back to mid lane and decides to pick up some last hits. Is noob throwing the harassy fire that burns it. Oh, it burns so bad. Okay, Banzakun alone. Nacho Cheese stealthing in, going for the leap. Gets the leap, and Banzakun is probably dead here. Doesn't have Haunt to get out of here, and there it is. Blows up the Spectre. The dangers of the Slark showing itself here as he has that region of Shadow Dance. He's already back to full health as they smoke up and look for somebody in the woods. Terps fan be looking for the call engage as they wander around this map. They see the Venge, they ping her out. Venge going, but there's a Shadow Rune. Can she get out of distance of the Observer Ward? Yes. They drop another one though. Oh no. Oh, they saw it, got the call. The call pulling her out of invisibility as she gets just destroyed. So they find the Observer wards, but they don't move in to destroy them as Minjit kind of Gets them out. There's the invisibility from Nacho Cheese. Dupe throws the ice path, but he gets the bounce off, and that's going to be it for Noob as he gets culled. But here comes a Shadow Strike on the other end. Opposite end. Crackle Knot dropping the double edge. There's going to be Nacho Cheese falling, and the axe just in the Static Storm by himself as Hayuken moves up and tries goes for Blazkowicz. He's never going to live through this. Boom! Stomped into the ground. Blink out from Queen of Pain, and it's gonna be a 3-for-1 trade for the Jakiro. Not worth it. And they get the free 50 gold from the observers. Hayuken moving back up as they ping out the stacked camp for somebody, letting him know that this really looks like a triple stack, actually. That's gonna be a decent amount of gold going for somebody. Axe blinks out as he sees Hayuken coming in on this terrifying. A Viper. Got his Ring of Aquila off for now. Doesn't want to be pushing too hard. And Bantaku moving up. He's porting back bot lane before he gets caught out by this. Ooh, Nacho Cheese looking for that juicy, juicy Spectre kill. Oh, weak off. Trying to hold the mid lane for himself. Picking up some levels.
Do something about that bottom tower.
Oh, here comes the ice path down onto Tripstran. Blinking from Krogonaut, but he's diving a little too deep. He gets blown up by Minjin on the back lines as they need to get out of here. She blinks in and screams, and they're going to shoot some fire at her to back her off. Noob got the ice path. There's a blink in from Tripstran as he turns around. Is he going to get the call? Oh, he gets the call before the ice path comes out. There's the spikes, but Tripstran looks like he might have to pay for this, but he gets the lucky spins. And, oh, no kill. Going the opposite way. Craggle Knot on the Centaur War Runner and the Noob going down as well on that poor Jakiro. So this brings us to 11-11, but the net worth really tipping heavily in the favor of FactSet. Even though they got the Hayugan on the top, this Spectre is really where they're running into some problems. BKB coming out for the Queen of Pain. That's going to be a lot to deal with all of the magic damage coming out. Because you got none of your stuns to control the Queen of Pain when she blinks in. So she can blink, just scream and everything. They see Nacho Cheese. They ping him out. Stun going on to Weak Off, though, as Nacho Cheese goes for the leap on Bantakun, who throws the dagger and just wants to get out of here. Noob thrown out of the ice path. They see Nacho Cheese, who uses his ultimate to get out. As Minjit blinks out and they lose the lion. There's the stampede coming out. They don't want him to get away. There's the stun on Nacho Cheese. Noob thrown out the dual breath, but there's a blink in from Terpstran, who gets the call on the Kragonaut. Super important to let Nacho Cheese get away, but he's still getting harassed down by this BKB dropped by Minjit as she's trading blows with Hayuken, who manages to get out. Terpstran getting the kill on Kragonaut on the back end, but looks like he's going to go for Noob now, who needs to get out of here. Oh, there they go. They turn around from Hayuken as it trades an axe for Kragonaut in the end. Well, I guess it was axe and lion. So, a little bit ahead for Team NVIDIA in that trade. A lot of team fighting in these these engagements. Bantakun, meanwhile, stayed safe and just used his haunt to get in and get out.
Dire's mid-tower won't last much longer. Radiant's top tower is taking hits.
Radiant's top tower?
No breaking down the Radiant structures like
that. Gonna probably be falling to,
Radiant's top tower is in bad shape.
There it is.
Just couldn't save that bottom tower. Radiant swoop.
Tower for tower trade. Tower. Coming in, but it Radiant's looks like, could use a hand. The Spectre got the deny, so coming up a little ahead for Team NVIDIA. Minjit not blinking out fast enough. Ooh, there it is. Almost got stomped. Oh, Kragonaut saw where she was going. She grabs the battery room, turns around. He drops goes the stomp. There's the slice, the double edge, but her blink's going to be back off cooldown. And there she goes, just into the forest. Into the wild. It's coming up against that Queen of Pain is really, really tough because she has the escape mechanism and everything. You really have to burst her down. It's hard to get a solo kill on her unless she makes a mistake and decides to fight beyond her means. Hayuken picking up a double damage rune, the Berry of Destiny, as Queen of Pain activates the banner rune to get that sweet bottle going. Axe bullying out Bantakun at this top lane, and he needs to be careful. He's about to get dunked here as he just daggers right and TP's now. Out. Does he get the call? Last second, doesn't get the call. Whew, that was a very scary situation for this Spectre, who needs to get that Radiance online so that way her ult can be particularly scary. Viper moving to the woods, gonna make sure he has all the farm he can handle. as he picks up a Yasha to increase his attack speed and farming rate. Bantakun healed up and wandering back out to the bottom lane. And Kragonaut pushing out the top lane. He has his Blink Dagger now, which should make a big difference in fights. Picks up a casual cloak, a little bit of spell resistance from this Queen of Pain's blast damage. And you know, help deal with the finger. A lot of good reasons to pick up a casual cloak. As the smoke up, they see Noob. And Noob sees them. Does he get out, though? Yeah, he's out. So they're just going to be sitting in here and kind of wasting their time as Hayuken grabs the illusion. I don't know if Terpstram really thought this one out. Might want to... There's the stun. Oh, as Minjin gets the kill on Jakiro, but they're going to be trading the axe. It's a good trade for NVIDIA. Oh, as warping in, Kragonaut gets glimpsed out. Hayuken coming in looking for some kills, but decides he's not going to make it. They ping out the other team, but not much they can do. Yep. They saw the Observer Ward, so they know it's there, but their own ward being destroyed before anything can happen. Wake up! There we go,
trouble
so...
in that Radiant's bottom tower.
Everybody just kind of dancing around each other. There's the recipe for that sacred relic. Bring up 5 more damage and the Radius Burn, making Spectres... Haunt really terrifying in these situations as Kragonaut has moved and he's cleaning up that triple stack that they set up for him. He needs to be careful though here. If he's not careful, his double edge will kill him. Probably a nice safe stomp coming out from the Kragonaut. Nope, he's just gonna hack him to death with the giant axe. Cool. So, NVIDIA, by saving themselves from a few fights, have really balanced out. They want that Spectre back up there and she's really hard to stop the farm from. And a Manstyle coming out for Viper. That's going to be a lot of damage to deal with in these team fights, and they don't really have a good answer for him. They haven't shut him down at all, really. And there it is, the Radiance. Love that item on Spectre. Nacho Cheese got his Shadow Blade up, and he's looking for this Spectre. You can tell he's on the hunt specifically for that. He's running through. Doesn't look like he's going to find her. Sees the attempt at stacking, but will he go to see who stacked it, or is he just... Nope, just going to... get some licks in on it. Oh, Vinny deciding, hell yeah, they're gonna defend this tower as they drop the blinks, but he gets glimpsed back. Oh, aggravating for poor Kragonaut on that. He got blinked all the way, he got glimpsed all the way back to base.
Radiant's mid tower's getting banged.
So they see Nacho Cheese over here with his observer ward. Maybe they did. They know he's in the area as there's a DD on this. Terrifying
Radiant's
Viper.
Mid tower's coming apart.
See if they find anybody as they head towards mid. Okay, they ping him out. They know they're there. Here comes the haunt. And that doing a lot more damage than it did in previous fights. Oh my god! Just blowing up the Slark from this DD Hayuken on the Viper. Here comes Terps fan, blinks out. He's going to be okay. Well, look at this Radiance just burning down. Tread's also up for the Spectre. A little bit of survivability. Never hurt anybody. Oh, double blink out from Minjit as Kragonaut blinks in. Things starting to heat up. Scouting. Oh, they get a glimpse of Weak off and ping him out as... Ah, they take down the Observer Ward. And limit the vision of Team Factset. Who don't... Team Factset does not want to fight without this Slark. The Slark does a ton of their damage. And Essence shifts away from Hayuken. Hayuken, as long as Hayuken has full damage, it's going to be a very big problem for Team Factset. Minjit bottled up. Got the Null Talisman to help deal with a bit of the magic damage coming out from Jakiro and Spectre and everybody, so... Looks like they're just going to go back mid lane as Spectre garbles some nonsense in my ear.
The dire might want to.
We're gonna wait for this rune spot. Oh, invisibility for Kragonaut. That is an excellent ward to have and not spotted out, so. Smoke coming out though from Blaskovich and Terpsfan. Terpsfan porting top though, breaking his smoke, goes for the call, missed leap. Hayuken needing to get out of here. There's the. Oh no. The ult from the Center War One are not gonna be enough. All the damage finally taking down. Poor Hayuken in this top lane. But they're gonna get the Disruptor as a trade, and Nacho Cheese turns around, goes for Kragonaut, gets the pounce! There's the spikes, and it's just the same story. Round two, Noob, no, what are you doing? Round three, it's gonna be a 3-for-1 trade, going the Team FactSet is LDC needs to port the way out of there. No haunt coming out because I think it was on cooldown for... it wasn't on cooldown. Oh, that's awkward. So awkward. I guess he thought he had low enough health that they would just blow up his illusions and it wasn't worth it. The one by one going in there, not the way to do it, as the burst damage and crazy lockdown from Team FactSet just keeping everybody in line. So with that, Terps fans gonna move down and get ready to hack up some creep waves as they move, trying to get a tier 2 tower off of this maybe, but I don't know if they're gonna have enough time with these respawn timers. They're gonna get a few licks in. Well, they're just immediately glyphing. Kind of a.
Trying to bust down Radiant structures.
Screw you guys, go home. Poured in from Hayuken as he grabs that farm. They ping him out because they got the Observer Ward, letting everybody know it's probably okay to get back to your lanes. Bonsakun up to 1700 gold again, so he's doing fairly well. Krogonaut picking up a Hood of Defiance. Not too terrible. These Observer Wards have been doing some work for Team NVIDIA. They want to remain safe on this level. Is this going to be able to see? No, it's just out of range, so. Okay, so there's some warning coming out from Team FactSet as they ping out to defend mid-tower. There's Noob picking up a rune. Hayuken, meanwhile, going to try to get this top tower as he was originally planning to before he got ganked. And he gets the last hit.
Dire's got one last top tower.
I wonder what he'll build next.
Tower ain't a pretty sight right now.
Port in. Mid-tower, look like there's going to be some pressure coming out from Team FactSet as Nacho Cheese ports in on the Slark. Ooh, there's the spikes coming out. And we'll see if they can get this tower. Nobody really close enough to help defend it. And it does not have a lot of health. Dude, throwing out the ice path, but Nacho Cheese just using the dark pact, so there's a bit of dispersion. Oh no! The ult coming in for Nacho Cheese. He needs to be careful. He might just get burned down by the Spectre. Ooh.
Radiant disowning their bottom tower.
Radiant disowning the bottom tower is weak off. Bonsakun just going to burn him down as he dives down. Hayuken getting the kill on the Disruptor. A 2-for-nothing trade as they go in. And they even have bottom disowned as they dive in on the Axe, who's going to try to get the Krogonaut kill. Misses the stop. There's the swap back as he gets just thrown into hell. A 4-for-nothing trade as they not going to move into the Roche Pit. They're going to move up and try to get this mid-tier 2 tower, it looks like. So they're going to clean up this creep wave. Now this terrifying Spectre showing herself. Got a Yasha, got a Radiance, and that's pretty much all she needs to be scary at this level in the game. Coming in, burn down the creep wave as Jakiro denies the mid tower. I think that's every tower being denied by NVIDIA in this game so far. They force out a glyph on a tier 2, which is something you always like to get because it doesn't look like they're gonna get the tower anyway. Yep, there it is, Jakiro getting the last hit. So they ping out a defend on the top from the Dire side. We'll follow LDC as they wander around. So far, Krogonaut's been fairly effective, but he's just been glimpsed back so many times, he needs to be very careful. Ooh, Haste Rune pinged out by the Spectre. Is she gonna grab it? Yeah, there it is. Grabs it and heads into the woods. Mine! You can picking up a Bounty Rune. I just love the Viper. Mine! Alright. So, things looking kind of bad for FactSet. They need their Queen of Pain to start getting in there doing some damage, but she hasn't been really there for the team fights as much as she could have been. She's got an Ultimate Orb picked up. Probably turn that into an Eye of Scotty. Help the slow down and control of this team. As they move up, they're looking for Krogonaut. They know he's here somewhere, but he's already made his way out of the jungle. Moves in, doesn't see any... Just blocking those... Body blocking that camp, I guess, preventing some farm going their way. So the farm fest continues as Bonsakun picks up an ultimate orb. I wonder what he's going to turn that into. There's a lot of things that'll be useful on this Spectre, so. It's over, just checks the shop. As they might be going for this bottom tier too, with the. That Radiance push is insane. And it really helps the farming of the Spectre, who's now moved into the second net worth. It's not what you want to see if your team FactSet. As they move together as a team, they're going to look for either a pickoff I thought they were going for the tower, but they're moving in. They want somebody to come and deal with them. Kragelnot, though, getting baited in. He sees Minjit, and he's like, he knows they won't let her roam on her own. Scout from LDC doesn't see anything, but there's the Spectre Haunt that sees everything. Gets a lot of burn damage up on the week off. Bontekun coming in, gets spiked, though, as the team is forced to run off. In the mid, they get the blow-up on the poor Queen of Pain. And Lion, as everybody else forced to TP away. Remember, always carry a TP. Viper will move into the forest, trying to get some kills, but he'll just end up taking their nice little stacks. Kragelnot sees the creeps, blinks over to him, stop, double edge. This one guy is like, hey, yeah, I'm alive. Oh no, he got killed. The life of a creep, never a fun thing. And then, so they'll be moving in to take this next tier 2 tower. I don't see why not. There's no, without the Queen of Pain and the Lion, their control goes down significantly.
Top tower, you know the drill.
So here comes the Manta's illusions, and look at this thing just drop. No glyph even available for it. Not for another minute.
Dire's lost the top tower.
So 3 tier 2s to 1 remaining for Team NVIDIA. They drop awards so they can see any Slarkin coming, and they just use the illusions. Look at these illusions. They're so tanky. They can farm by themselves. And you can really do them well. Picks up his Ag Scepter. Ooh. That's right. Increased mana cost and cooldown and increased range on this Viper Strike, which is already scary in its own. Axe moving out by his own, clearing out this creep wave, not using any call or anything. He wants to save it in case he's in trouble. Spectre sees him though. Nope. Yep, she does. Oh, she's just using the burn to camp through to get the kill through the trees as this guy runs around and just burn. He's like, I'm gonna get you. As Axe TPs out and heads for mid. Let's see if they clear up these. Wow, the path not taken melee creep getting blocked off. They can probably get some decent tower damage in, but Bontekun, it's just like a party for him. Look at this. He just stands in there, and look at all of this. 52, 48, 40. Just so much farm going for him. Oof, disgusting. As he's up to another 2,000. They drop it. Oh no! Not sure she's gonna initiate into this. He misses the pounce. As the stampede is dropped, link in from Minjit, who doesn't get anybody, drops his PKB in panic. Noob might get killed here if he's not careful. There's the scream doing it. LDC comes in, throws the drop. They get the line in the background. Hugo just standing in this ult, shooting stuff around. He's so tanky. Drops the mech. Nacho Cheese diving in even deeper, but the swap out, keep out Hugo safe. It's a 4-for-1 trade as Queen of Pain is forced to run away. Oh, the Spectre is just terrifying now. With the tankiness of Hayuken, this is going to be a really difficult thing to handle as the Viper Strike back on cooldown because of that Aghanim Scepter. And 3,200 gold. Scythe the Vice, though. Big game changer coming out for the Queen of Pain. With that, she can get a solo kill on a lot of these heroes. Actually, she could probably get a kill on Hayuken if she does pulls her cards right. Even the tankiest of heroes. When you're a sheep, there's no defending yourself against the Queen of Pain. But looks like this is going to cost them another tower. They got a glyph for fortification this time. Probably going to pop it in that's half a second. Oof. Look how fast they popped it, but it doesn't matter. It just goes down so quickly. It's going to be gone before this Slark's back, and you can't defend this without the Slark. So they look to push high ground. It looks like they'll be okay going back and just handling Minjit. That sounds so dirty for some reason. All right. Oh, there's the... The explosion coming out, Minjit blinks out though. Mantis style picked up by the Spectre as well as they move through this tower. All the slices. Man, this can be these high damage illusions that they have radiance as well as, and then the haunt in the middle of that, a team fight. Just the burn damage coming out from Bontekun is insane at this point. She picks up a Reaver walking through the secret shop. They probably turn that into a Heart of Tarrasque to make her just unkillable. Kragelnot, meanwhile, you know, he picks up a Temp Portal Scroll. Not much item progression for him. Let's see. The Viper, still saying at the same stuff. Picks up a Talisman of Evasion, probably turn that into a Butterfly. Dude, same story. Bontekun needs to be careful here. He's pretty low on health. He might even drop the, he's just using the illusions to tank it up. Whew. That is just crazy damage. Look at them. They just fall. Somebody pings out. Somebody saw something, started to ping it out, but there you go. Yule Scepter picked up by LDC. That'll help keep him safe from a lot of things, actually. Pop it up and give people enough time to either haunt in or blink in. It's a really good pickup. As Kragonaut goes for the TP bottom, I'll push out this lane. Atrochi's finishing up the creep stack as he picks up an ultimate orb. Probably turn that into an Eye of Scott. He puts his Orb of Venom that he's had the whole game into his stash while he waits to finish off that. He probably will wander up and finish that now. Let's watch him. Nope. Doesn't have a goal. Terps fan. Picks up his Ag Scepter. Always good for Axe because you get the that kill threshold. Easy dunks. And with a high health hero such as Viper, you really want to get that Ag Scepter going. So this could make a lot of difference in the upcoming fights. Oh, this Blink Dagger up for the Lion to help his positioning. And looks like a headdress. So probably the start of a mech on Blazkowicz. That mech has been making, I think, really the biggest difference in these fights. As it makes just that burst of health, keeping everybody alive. Dude, but you can wander around. Oh, Heart of Tarrasque! Just purchased by the Centaur Warrunner. That now his initiation is going to make sure he can't. I don't even think they can burst him down now. The trick is he's got to get it. So coming in on the courier though right now. Ancient Stack. Pretty much the best farm option for the Dire side at this point. They're looking around. Nobody's going for Roche, though. I think you can get a good sneaky Roche in a lot of points right now. As Axe moves in. Gonna see Meat Spectre here. Is that gonna be enough? Yeah, he's just like, screw that. He's out. Blinks in, no. He's going for it. Really gutsy move considering just the insane amount of health I'm about to go in. I don't know what he was thinking there. Maybe he's thinking it'll do the damage and then Queen of Pain will blink in and finish off. There's the blinks in, BKB, Matsukun just walks away. Turned into a pig though. Here comes the spikes. Can they get the kill? Drez dropped the ultimate, but there's the blink in. Swap out as LDC saves the visage. And that's going to be the Queen of Pain down. And along with Baskovich on the disruptor. A 4-for-0 trade again going the way of Team NVIDIA. That team fight though. Jeez. This is going to be, it's so hard to kill the Spectre. Uh-oh, Kragonaut catching out Nacho Cheese on the Slark. He's just going to get away. He's going to have to use his Shadow Blade to get out of this. Yeah. Is that hearted up Kragonaut with so much health. They move into the Roche Pit, and this is going to be an easy free Roche. Easiest Roche of your life. Look at it just falling down and down. Spectre's Heart of Tarrasque finished up just to make her extra, extra hard to kill. And there's the Eye of Scotty. Finished for the Slark. The Radiant took old Roche out back and everybody's like, oh yeah, somebody needs to take the Aegis, huh? I was like, don't worry. I just needed to go finish that off. Aiken picks up the Bounty Rune as they head back mid. Whew. Dust purchased from LDC to help handle this Slark. This Kragonaut's just... These two double heart heroes just wandering up. They're like, what? What are you going to do? Head just picked up by Kragonaut. Interesting. I wonder if he'll be building a mech of his own or if he'll go into another item. Nacho Cheese knowing he needs to stay out of fights. Just going to be over here farming up the jungle. They might be looking to push high ground here. As I see why the hell not. They've been dominating and haunt just about up again. So, got the Aegis walk up. Stand on the front line. Oh, the stomp on Minjin. He does get the BKB off and there's the slices. Gets the BKB off and blinks out. Woo! Very close one for the Queen of Pain there. Nacho Cheese trying to engage on the back lines, but he gets swapped back into hell and blown up. Macropie doing a ton of damage to him. Stomp coming out. There's the blink in from Kragonaut. The call from Terps fan, but not the right call against the Kragonaut who just recovers all of his health so quickly. Stun coming out of Minjit. And there's the blow up. The finger not even enough to finish off Kragonaut. His weak off gets messed up by Bonsacoon. There's the frozen. Huh? Oh, glimpse back on Bonsacoon, trying to keep him safe, and they finally get a return kill on the Jakiro. Bonsacoon moving to the top line, and there's the GG called by Terps fan. Oh, as soon as that Spectre came online, it's just too hard to deal with. And there goes the Ancient. Woo! Oh, Troll Warlord. That was an intense battle. It looked like it was going to be a very even game, and then the Spectre just coming and mopping up, letting the team win enough fights. Whew, look at that craziness. The Viper, of course, hollowing off, topping off the kills just with his insane amount of damage early game. He really helped this team turn this game back around. It was looking kind of dangerous there from FactSet. So another win for Team NVIDIA. All right, guys. I hope you liked it, and I'll keep this this rolling as often as I can. I gotta love having a team you can follow. All right, guys. I'm out.